Welcome back everyone to Forza Horizon 3. We found another barn find. So let's see what it is. Hopefully it's something really good, because the last couple have been. And don't want to disappoint. Oh yeah. Reliant Robin. Well,
it's
or Regal even.
Regal. This is a classic piece of British motoring history. You keep digging up classics at this rate and this time next year, you'll be a millionaire.
The Regal was the van version and the Robin was the normal passenger version, so that's why we've I got a little bit confused there, but well yeah, it's super van 3.
Cute little guy fixed up. Should still be a hoot to drive when it's finished.
Yeah, if it doesn't keep rolling over. Right, we've actually got another barn find to find as well that's in close proximity, so let's get up there.
In 100 yards.
And that Maserati is ready as well, so we'll take a look at that when we found this one. Because that is a car I've been waiting for a long time to be finished. And yeah, I'm in the Crown Victoria from the recent car pack, which, and this is one of my favourites from that car pack, despite its inherent flaw of having an awful automatic gearbox. Right, let's wade for this river. Out the way, Monte Carlo.
Turn right.
Yeah, the problem with this automatic gearbox is it strangles all the power. Which it doesn't have a lot of in the first place, but it would be a whole lot better of a car if you had a more, you know, a better automatic or even a manual. I still like the car nonetheless. So that's plenty of charm, a nice V8, plenty of torque.
Yards, you will arrive at your destination.
Right, where's this barn finder? It's a bit more open wide this part. So it's a bit easy to see things. It's definitely not you. You're just a house. There is a barn over there, I think. This one? Nope. No, busy. Leave me alone, Anna. Sorry about your fence. I don't think it's going to be here, this is a little town. It's got some XP. Let's try over here. I've already tried this bit, haven't we? Something similar. Let's try over here, on the other side of this part where we found those boards. Aha! Found you! What's it gonna be? something else really good as well. We've had a few good cars in a row so far. And you might think that's weird saying it about a Reliant Supervan, but at least it's something interesting, something we've never had before. Right now. What's that? A Ford Falcon?
Ooh. 73 Falcon XB, 5.8 litre V8.
Now again, we've had this before, but
fuel-injected suicide machine. You might have to give me a minute.
Yeah, we've had this car before in the previous Forza Motorsport games and even Forza Horizon, I think, but it's still at least a good car, unlike the Ferrari Dino, which we've had before and isn't a good car.
Yeah, sorry about that outburst. It's an Australian thing. I'll get it cleaned up and report back.
Okay then, right. We're gonna go and go all the way back to our festival, so I'll see you there and we'll have a look at the Maserati. So yeah, see you when we get there. Right, so this Maserati is ready, so let's collect it.
The Pininfarina Berlinetta. They made four of these. Four, that's it. And now we're standing in front of one. I'm telling you, this feeling is what I live for.
What a beautiful, beautiful car. So let's take a look at it in Forza Vista when we eventually get into it. Yeah, this is a gorgeous, gorgeous Maserati. We don't have enough old Maseratis in any of the Forza games, quite frankly, and yeah, this is a treat. Let's open the bonnet. Ooh, that's beautiful. I think it's got a straight six engine in it, but I'll have to look that up to make sure. Beautiful interior. No boot, because this was a Maserati back in the day and they didn't really care about practicality. But yeah. Great looking interior, like the blue dials. Yeah, this is what I call magic. Let's start her up. I'm not sure what engine it has. I swear I heard somewhere that it was a straight six, but then again, it could be anything. So let's just take a look at the stats. So yeah, it's got 170 horsepower, 135 pounds-feet of torque from a 2-litre engine. Yeah, it probably is either a straight 6 or a very small V8. But then again, we have had small V8s on this game before from that Fiat 8V Supersonic. So yeah, it wouldn't surprise me. And it weighs a mere 1,984 pounds. So yeah, even though it doesn't have all that much power, it's stupidly light. And that comes ahead in the acceleration. Doesn't have all that good braking, but the handling looks pretty solid. And as you can see, it's worth 2 million credits. So yeah, let's take it out and let's go do some more racing. Right, so let's have a look at what we've got to do. Right, we've got a circuit race there. Another circuit race there. Sprint race. I think we've already done that one though. Let's go down here. It's quite close. Rev's quite high as well at more than 7,000 RPM.
200 yards. Turn right. Turn right. You have arrived at your destination.
Feels a bit like AJ, a hairy car.
You've now set up enough routes to host a championship. Points awarded over multiple races, most points wins. You know what to do.
Well, let's get going then. Can we not drive this? Well, we'll do one in. We'll do our own blueprint then. We'll do a barn find series. Create blueprint. Let's go. We'll get to see a few barn finds then while we do it.
Championship. Cleaning out the shed has never been this much fun.
So yeah, we've obviously got the other ones to choose from. But because I've just got the Maserati, I'm going to go for that. See what it really can do. Because it might well look great, but whether or not it can drive great against other cars is to be seen, but hopefully it will do. I'm still not disappointed that it is a barn find, because yeah, it's a car we've never had before, and it's certainly up the roster for older classic Italian cars. So yeah, we've got the Ford from the 40s to go against, we've got a Jag, we've got the buggy thing to go against. Let's just have a look at the starting grid. So yeah, we've got the Mayor's Manx, so that's that little beach buggy kind of thing. We've got the 1946 Ford Wagon, we've got the Toyota FJ40. I know this kind of ruins some of the cars that we're going to find, but there are plenty more rare barn finds than there is here, and that Holden 50. I think that's the super van. So let's get going. We have a Maserati in here as well. Yeah, oh no, that Holden is that van over there, that pickup ute thing. Not the super van like I thought. It's a treat to see all these kind of different cars going against each other though. That Reliant was on its side then. Look at it. Oh dearie me. I can't wait to drive that Manx though. If you've never seen the film For Your Eyes Only, the James Bond film, then you'll not know why I like that car so much, but yeah, it's featured in that film. A crucial scene. Used really, really well as well. Right, it's me, the Jag, and the Ford in podium positions, which is surprising considering that Ford is a huge car which is rolling all over the place. Just notice where the fuel filler cap and pipe is. It's right behind your head. So if you got hit into the side or something, you'd have fuel gushing all over you. Yeah, that would be a fiery death in this car. Love where the exhausts are though on the side. This thing sounds amazing though. Whee! Likes to drift as well. Who knew this old car could do such a thing? So for a car that's not even got 200 horsepower, it's got some serious poke to it. You have to agree on that. Might well not be the fastest car we've ever found in a barn find, but certainly one of the most charismatic ones. Though I do still prefer the Jaguar overall in terms of barn finds. This definitely comes second. Just glad they've put in at least several cars that have never been in the series before for the barn finds, and not just filled it with cars we've had before. Granted, we have found three so far that have been in the in at least one Forza game before, but at least two of those three are actually good cars. Though you could easily argue the case that they should have been in the game's normal garage from the start. But then again, it's probably hard for them to think of cars that they haven't put in the series to put in the barn finds that people wouldn't mind having to find first. So yeah, it's a compromise to have. Just glad we got the Ferrari Dino out of the way first. It's all been uphill from there. Love to know where they found one of these to scan, etc. Because, like I said, there's only four of them in the world, or four ever made. I don't know how many there are left. Wouldn't be surprised if that number's even less. Whoa! Wouldn't wonder how much of the how much these sell for in real life. A fair amount if there's only a few of them around. And there we go, get the win. That was a pretty easy race to be honest, but it was funny seeing that Reliant go all over the place. And predictably, both of them come last, which is no surprise, considering how roly-poly they were. But I am surprised that the Ford came fourth ahead of the Mayor's Manx. Yeah, that is a surprise. Yeah, we'll do this whole championship this episode. No point splitting it up. Some more credits. More XP. Get another spin prize. Give me some more money. Or a nice car. One or the other. Been getting really low amounts lately on the wheel spins, but luckily they do double, so it's not as low as it could be. More fans. We've actually been ready to open a new festival now as well.
Onwards and upwards, boss. I've got a short list of locations for site number 3. Just look at the map and point. I'll do the rest.
I think we'll go for it.
Oh. Natural habitat of kangaroos and reptiles and all-wheel drive. Or the Yarra Valley. Australian wine country. Perfect if you want the blur outside your window to be a lovely green.
I think we'll go for the outback because we did deny that the last time around with the surface paradise. So let's unlock that.
Check out our new festival location when you're ready. No rush. This is Australia. The outback isn't going anywhere.
Yeah, figured that. So it's all the way over there. As you can see, it's a lot less dense, a lot less around, but should be fun for off-roading. But we're going to continue with this Barn Find Championship. Oh, it wants me to set the route. Oh. You said no rush, and now you're making me set the route.
Welcome back, Jake.
I want to continue with the championship. Where is it? Right, up here.
We're part way through a championship. Would you like me to set a route for the next race event for you? In 100 yards, keep left.
Right, we'll go there and we'll, oh, look, Reliant Superman next to us. You're going to roll over again? Go on. It's hilarious. Please. Way there he goes. So yeah, we're gonna go up here and start this next race, so see you when we get there. Right, second race in this championship. I got word while driving on the way to this race that the Reliant Supervan is ready, so we'll take a look at that at the end of this championship, see what it's all about, and laugh at it falling over. Where were they this time? They're both at the back because that's where they placed in the last race. I'm guessing that's why. But it's pure coincidence. Can't wait to drive that Toyota FJ40 and that Ford. Yeah, all of these cars that I haven't tried yet, I really can't wait to drive. I really like just after post-World War American cars like that Ford. Really rather interesting to me. As you can see, it looks hilarious to drive, wobbling all over the place. I think it's a Manx in third, a Jag in second, and a Manx again in first. Inside. I've got way more power than you, Manx. Might well be really, really light. Don't have the guts. I'm guessing the two at the rear end of this pack are the Reliant. really enjoying this Maserati. Love its speed, I love its acceleration. Really like the noise, looks great, and it's fun to drive. Might not be perfectly great in terms of handling or anything like that, but it's really rather fun. I don't really get enjoyment out of cars that have perfect dead-on handling. I prefer a car that you can wrestle around and slide all over the place and have to actually drive rather than... I like to drive a car rather than be driven by the car, if you know what I mean. Beautiful lighting on that exhaust pop. Really do like the way this game looks. I've really put far more detail into this game than previous Forza Horizon games. Not as much as I would like, but they've definitely improved it. It's a good sign of what may come in the next game, and hopefully what will come in Forza Motorsport 7, which should be out next year, hopefully. The Forza series in general is my most played and most owned game series, because I've got 9 games now. 9. Soon to be 10 when Forza Motorsport 6, 7 comes out. And there we go, another good win. These are a bit easier because I'm going up against cars that are generally...
ribbons and gold medals, boss. How about a nice pat on the back?
Gladly. But yeah, these cars aren't, apart from the Mayors and maybe the Jaguar, the rest of the cars aren't really all that good in terms of drivability, so that's why it's been a bit easier to drive, or win, should I say. Right, let's go into the next race, after we've checked out all our XP credits and fans. Certainly getting some good money, nearly levelled up again. Fans, we're less than 100,000 away from the next festival, though we've still got to open the other one yet.
Oi, got your XP Falcon down here, ready to pick up.
Good, we'll check that out as well when we've done this championship.
There's an ongoing championship that you're taking part in. Would you like me to set a route to the next race event for...
Yeah, have you done it right? Yes, you have. Let's go. Not the best launch on this car, but makes up for it for its charisma. Yeah, again, we'll see you when we get to that race. Right, I think this is the third and final race. Had a good streak so far. Well, can't always guarantee a win. You're winning easily, and now tougher drivers want to challenge you. Would you like to raise a duplicate high skill to expert and use 25% extra credits? Okay. Right, let's go. Increase the difficulty now. I'm glad it told me that, because I wasn't really sure whether or not I was doing great or just about winning. Obviously I am winning substantially ahead of everyone else. I still don't expect this to be especially difficult though, because of the kind of cars we're driving. I mean, as good as those Manxes are in terms of handling and being all lightweight, etc., they certainly don't have the power on my car. As you can see, reeling them in really easily. But it should be more difficult come next any races that I'm in more modern cars. Oh dear. Span out there, so not as easy as I was expecting. longer race this one. Love the noise this car makes at the top end. You really can't beat 50s and 60s Italian cars for the most part for engine noises, especially Maseratis and Ferraris. Kind of thing I want in the next Forza Motorsport game though is dynamic weather and environment. We were racing at night and now it's daytime. This changes it up a bit and makes it more unique each time you race, instead of, you know, predetermined rain or predetermined daylight. Liking these circuits races a lot as well. They really are well thought out. You can definitely tell that they've shaped the world to fit the kind of racing aspects of the game. That's what I liked about that game, Driver San Francisco, is they might have well have been basing it on a real city, but they changed it up a bit to make it more fun to drive around. And that's a kind of open world kind of game kind of thing I'm more of a fan of. Realism is all well and good, but unless it's fun to be actually driving around, because you are playing a game after all, you don't play a game to be bored or take you back to where you might be in real life. You play it to have fun, and that's what these circuit races are doing. They're making the open world aspect more fun. There we go, another first place, even though the difficulty went up. Sure. Right, there we go. I think that's the championship over with.
Hey, Jake. You just bagged your first championship win of the summer. Nice work.
Thank you. More money. XP, we've leveled up, so we get a spin prize. What is it? Some good, please. 30 grand, now 60. Yes, finally some big money, not some for a while. And fans have well gone up. So yeah, we're gonna go to the festival site that we've already set up in Surfers Paradise and take a look at the two barn finds that we've got. So see you when we get there. Right, let's take a look at these barn finds. Got two of them. First up, the Reliant Supervan from 1972. He said 1967 in the part that when he announced when it was ready, but oh well.
I know it's only got three wheels. I know you only need a motorbike license to drive one. I know it was a running joke on British telly, but, you know, I just can't help but love this thing.
Same here. So let's give it a go. After we take a look at it, obviously. Let's get in it. Now, if you don't know anything about British culture or anything like that, this is featured in a comedy sitcom series called Only Fools and Horses, and yeah, it was used as a running gag throughout the series, or its many years. It was, that TV show was around for decades, quite frankly. But yeah, pretty much a running joke for that, and also was used on Top Gear as well as a running joke as well. Tiny little engine, it's nothing all that big, but it certainly makes a difference in a car that doesn't weigh all that much, which we'll take a look at the stats in a minute. So let's look inside. Yeah, there you go, it's a pretty simple car, there wasn't really any frills on it, but that was the whole point. Right, let's take a look at the stats. So yeah, it's got a 32 horsepower, 38 pounds-feet of torque, 700cc engine. I think it's probably a twin-cylinder motorbike engine or something like that. And it only weighs 1,004 pounds, so yeah, extremely light. Probably the lightest car here, besides the Isetta, yeah. Obviously I've upgraded it so it weighs a bit more, but maybe the Isetta is lighter. I think it is. Let me just check that for you. I don't want to be wrong on something for you guys. BMW. Yeah, the Isetta is about 84 pounds lighter, but that Reliant Supervan is obviously more practical and obviously quicker and has more power. So let's go and take a look how it drives.
I keep hearing funny things about an old barn.
Another barn find. God, I've only just done
one.
You should
go check it out. The car, not the barn, obviously. Why would I?
So yeah, as you can see, it doesn't rev all that high. Certainly not the quickest thing going. But then again, when you've only got three wheels, you don't really want to be going all that fast, do you? Let's try and roll it. Yay, there we go. Yeah, not much else to say really. Sorry. Yeah, there's no way I could race this for real and actually win a race. Especially if you put more power into it. It'll be all over the place. But then again, that gives me an idea for a video. So expect to see that. I know there's a barn find rumour, but I'm currently enjoying another one already. So yeah, let's go back to the festival site and check out that Ford Falcon, because that is the other barn find that we've got. And then we'll end it there. Nice paint job. So yeah, let's take a look at this Ford Falcon. Oh, if we can actually get in there. Right, the Ford Falcon, let's take a look.
With this much horsepower, you will rule the wasteland. I asked the Horizon people if I could put on some spikes and crossbows and a flamethrower, but they said no.
I wonder why. So let's take a look at the stats of it. Get in it first. Obviously, if you've seen this car in previous Forza games, you already know all this, but for those who haven't, so yeah, 300 horsepower, 380 pounds-feet of torque from a 5.7-litre V8 engine. Maybe people round it up to 5.8, but whatever. And it only weighs 3,047 pounds. So yeah, despite not having all that much power compared to other muscle cars from that era, because the likes of the Pontiac Firebird Trans Am, for instance, from the same year, had like 365, something like that. So yeah, not all that much power, but it certainly weighs a lot less than other American muscle cars, for instance. So yeah. Certainly got the lightness on its side, and it still has a lot of torque as well, and it looks absolutely great, and it handles decently, and it's got good acceleration. Let's take a look at it in Forza Vista. Yeah, love the look of this car. Certainly one of the better looking muscle cars from that time. I like the graphics on it, etc. Great looking interior, which we'll take a look at in a minute, and then the boot, sizeable. Like a lot of muscle cars from that era. They were generally practical, but they were more about the speed than the practicality. And there's the interior. So let's take it out and have a quick look at it. So I'll see you when we get out there. So yeah, like a lot of muscle cars, big, loud, not all that high revving. Lots of oversteer, but lots of fun as well. After being in that Reliant, this is a bit weird, because I'm half expecting the car to roll over, though it obviously won't. Yeah, always liked this car ever since it was first put in a Forza game. And I'm glad it's made a return, even though it is a barn find. And then again, I guess this should be no surprise that it's a barn find in an Australian set game. So yeah, there we go. Bit of a barn find heavy game episode, should I say. But really fun nonetheless. And yeah, we've got 3 new cars to try out in future videos, whatever they may be. So yeah, thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.